And joining us from her home office in Mulgrave, which is about to get a lot busier over the next few weeks and into the next few months, is newly acclaimed municipal councillor for the town of Mulgrave, Krista Luddington. And Krista, first of all, congratulations. We're really, really excited that you're now part of council. How did you feel when you found out?
Thank you so much. And thanks for taking the time to chat, Adam. I appreciate that. I'm super excited. You know, that's all I can say about it. It's something that I've considered on and off now for quite some time. When the last election hit, we were very, very new in the community. And so it wasn't the right time. But now we've kind of laid our roots down and gotten to know the people, gotten to know the community that we've grown to love. And so it just felt like the right time.
So I'm curious to hear that you were interested in running in the last election as well in 2016. What's motivated you to want to be involved in municipal politics and to sit on town council? What did you have going for you that led you to this decision and led you to where you are right now?
Yeah, so I mean, it's something that municipal politics in particular, I've always had a special interest in. And, you know, I've tried to attend as many meetings as, you know, I could. And for the meetings that I couldn't make, I've always kind of got caught up with the minutes and just always wanted to know what was happening. I think that's extremely important to know what's going on in the community around you and surrounding communities, right? To be in tune with what's going on. And I think what inspired me to be a part of that was I enjoy change. You know, I've always been the type of person that I've wanted to kind of create and be creative. And so this really gives an opportunity to have a voice and be the voice for other people. And so it just only kind of made sense to me to pull that all together and to be able to do that in your hometown for the people that you love and just try and do the best that you possibly can and see where it goes.
It strikes me, thinking about your life, that you've always been involved, even as a teenager and even before then, at a volunteer level in so many different communities. You grew up in Dundee, obviously. You did that in St. George's Channel and Dundee and in Port Hawkesbury and various places around the Strait area. Can you tell me a bit about what it's like to get involved in a place like Mulgrave? You know, it seems that there's a special spirit that fills the town. Can you speak to me a little bit about that and about how that's really impacted you over the years that you and Jay and your children have been living there?
Yeah, so it's kind of funny, Adam. I still haven't been able to put my finger on it. So we moved in. It was just 4 years ago. So like I said, really, really fresh in the community when the last election hit. And so ever since we moved in, there is something magical about Mulgrave that I just can't put a finger on. I know it's the people. The people who live in Mulgrave are extraordinary. And I think that they are the town's best asset. You know, my husband and I, we play some music, and so we've put on different events, whether it be New Year's Eve or Halloween dances or what have you. And the amount of support and the amount of drive and excitement that fills a room when people from Mulgrave land there, it's like no other. And so it's really, really quite special. So getting involved, you know, right from when we first moved here, I quickly found out that Heather Brennan, who I know you've had on the show here before, she is incredible. She's a driving force in this community in the recreation department. And she handles all recreation from toddlers to seniors and everyone in between. And so she was someone that I was like, I really need to get to know. And so that's what I did. I kind of reached out to her here and there. It was, you know, typically about kids programs until you get to know each other a little bit. And then I wanted to join forces with her and see what I can do and see what we can do together to put on events in the community. And she's been wonderful. She's such an asset here. So, you know, kind of working alongside her in the recreation department and coming together on different events over the past 4 years has been amazing. And so I really am positive about what's to come with the new town council. There's some new faces. Town council up to this point have worked tirelessly. They've worked extraordinarily hard for the community. And so it's about continuing that work and seeing where it goes.
I'm glad you brought up Heather Brennan, the recreation director for Mulgrave, because I had her on the show just a few months ago, and that was in the middle of the pandemic, and she was planning all these different things. They weren't really slowing down at all, as much as you can do during an actual pandemic, but they were really rolling right along, and it seems that Mulgrave has always had that spirit, and I've noticed that both before and after you folks have moved there. So can you speak a little bit as well to the spirit of Mulgrave, even in the face of adversity, and it has struggled with adversity over recent years. It almost wasn't a town just 3 or 4 years ago. So can you speak to that spirit and how you hope to be able to play a larger role in the development of Mulgrave now that you're on town council?
Yeah, so, you know, even just with speaking with folks who have lived here their entire lives, you know, where we're so new in the community, I've got a ton to learn, and I know that. And the best way to learn is to talk to people and hear their stories and, you know, hear the issues that they're experiencing and even hearing about, you know, what Mulgrave used to be and what it was, right? And so you hear that a lot about it used to be such a booming town with so many different amenities and options. And unfortunately, that's not the reality right now. But with that being said, I do find that, you know, in the face of all of that, people are still positive. Like, they still have that genuine want for the town to succeed and to do well and to have all of these things again. Will it look the same as what it did 50 years ago, 60 years ago? Probably not, you know, in all honesty. However, I do think that it's important to see not where we were, but where we can be, you know, to be able to look forward, learn the lessons from where we were and take the good from that, and then kind of move it forward and see what we can do. There's so much potential here, and there's so many opportunities. You know, one of the things that I would love to see happen, we have the former Mulgrave School. Yeah. And there's, you know, there's lots of vacancies there, empty classrooms. What an awesome opportunity to turn that into an incubator for small business, new business, and see what we can do with that. Even just, you know, encouraging people, not just Mulgrave residents, but bringing people in from other communities, surrounding communities, and see if they would be interested in starting up shop right here in Mulgrave. I think that would be amazing. And I know there'd be support, because that's what Mulgrave does.
You know, we talked a little bit earlier about your volunteer work in both Mulgrave and around the Strait, but I don't know that everybody necessarily knows how much effort you've put into a lot of the real cornerstones of the Strait area, both inside and outside of Mulgrave. I mean, you've been a board member for the Strait Area Chamber of Commerce. You worked extensively at NSCC Strait Area Campus for a number of years. And most recently, your current position has you as an advertising executive at 101.5 The Hawk right now. So you're getting the experience that has had you not only seeing the state of the economy around here, but also working with others on a team. So does all of that bode well for you as you're settling in with your new council colleagues?
I think so. You know, I really like to consider myself as someone who can appreciate a different perspective. I like to work together as a team. I like to see change happen, as I said before. So if we have like-minded individuals who are open to thinking outside the box, because let's be honest, right now, I think there's a lot of constraints that may or could hold you back when it comes to Mulgrave. So there needs to be some creative thinking. There needs to be that thinking outside the box and coming up with new, fresh ideas. And as long as, you know, the people of the community are on board for that, and let's try different things and see what we can do, I think there can be a lot of magic happen here. Because it's already here. It's just to bring it out, right? So in terms of, you know, the other positions or volunteer positions that have kind of held over the years, I think a lot of those qualities that you kind of gain through each role that you play, you can definitely carry them forward and bring it into any new role or position that you may assume. So yeah, I'm really, really excited to work together and just to see what we can do. I think there's a lot of potential here for sure.
Well, I want to talk a little bit about the team that you have coming in, and it's kind of intriguing to see in Mulgrave with the municipal election happening that there is still a race for mayor, but you know who's going to be on council with you, and you have a couple of returnees as well, Tanya Snow, Bob Russell, and you have Ms. Durling as well, too, who is brand new to council just like yourself. So what's your sense on the group that you're going in with and what kind of work you folks will be able to do together?
Yeah, I'm really looking forward to it. I don't know Crystal Durling. I haven't had the chance to meet her yet, but I've creeped her on Facebook, I'm not going to lie. And we've exchanged contact information and we've added each other on Facebook and she seems very lovely and I'm really looking forward to working with her. As for Tanya and Bob, I did have some experience with them before. Tanya and I and Heather, we were the folks who started the Market by the Sea here in Mulgrave 3 years ago. And so, you know, I've worked with Tanya on that project and it's been great. And then with Bob, I was a part of the Mulgrave and Area Revitalization Committee for a bit at the very beginning. And so, you know, got to know Bob through that as well. And I think that if there's one thing that I can say about the council moving forward, it's a hardworking council. It's a council that seems to love the community. And I think that you're going to see some great things happen.
Last question for you, Krista, and this is just on a personal note. Obviously, you know, you need the support of not only the community, but also of your family to be able to make that run for municipal council, whether it's a successful run or not. And I imagine that you've got the support from Jay and from your girls as well, too. So can you tell me a little bit about what that was like and what was their reaction when you found out that you'd been a clique?
Yeah, so I mean, definitely the support is there. I would be lying if I didn't say I kind of flip-flopped back and forth a little bit on, you know, do I, don't I? Am I still too new in the community? Do I know enough? You know, can you learn? All of those things, right? And so what really pushed me over was my family talking to me, saying, you know, nobody knows everything at first. And, you know, we've been here 4 years and we've gotten to know some people, but what a great opportunity to talk to more people and to learn about the history and to learn about where residents want to see the community in 4 years and, you know, in the future. And so it was a lot of those types of talks that finally made me go, okay, all right, I'm going to pick up the package. I'm going to do it. And so, you know, certainly a ton of support in that way. And yeah, when we found out about the acclimation, it was very exciting. It was super exciting. I had a moment of, whew, this is happening. Okay, well, let's do this.
There's no campaign. I'm already there.
I'm already there. Yeah. So that was, it was an interesting feeling for sure. And yeah, I mean, Jay's been such a great support and he's very excited too to see where this goes.
Oh, that's wonderful. We've covered a lot of ground in a short time, Krista, and I appreciate you giving me some time here. Did you want to add anything else before we wrap up?
No, you know what? Thank you so much for taking the time to chat. And I'm really, really looking forward to the next 4 years and hopefully we'll get a chance to chat again.
Well, we're looking forward to it. And I suspect this is not the last time that I'll be interviewing you for Till Hill 24/7. But thank you so much. And congratulations on making your first successful jump to Mulgrave Town Council. Look forward to catching up with you again soon.
Thanks, Adam. Take care.
All right, you too. Krista Ludington is one of the newly acclaimed town councillors for Mulgrave, and we've been speaking to her at her home office via Zoom.